the Black Swan has become obsessed with the Riot Cabaret world title. Will he win it tonight? Or will this man hold on?
Chuck Mambo just watched his best friend get decimated on his 30th birthday in front of a message from his parents. I can't even begin to think.
Oh, Mambo!
Mambo!
Mambo with the surprise! Mambo catches him surprise with the wreath break! Chuck Mambo looking to avenge what happened to TK Cooper, as you say, Sean, on Cooper's 30th birthday. The Riot Cabaret World Champion not messing around here.
Title's on the line.
Mambo knocks him down. And Chuck Mambo is laser focused here on Cara Noir. Mambo tried to go to the corner, gets the elbow up though. Noir tried to follow him in.
Oh,
back elbow.
Almost sent Cara flying out of the ring. The history between Mambo and Cara Noir goes all the way back to our very first show at the grand opening. Chuck Mambo beat Cara Noir in the very first match in Riot Cabaret.
Yeah, all the way back, 28th of June last year. And as we know, later that night, that was an opening round match in the world title tournament. Chuck Mambo went on to win the title that night and has held on to it ever since.
But I don't think Cara's ever sort of gotten over.
Ooh, double axe handle.
He's never gotten
Mambo
over that loss.
No, I don't think he has. It was an ill-tempered Cara Noir, we know that.
Cara Noir attacking Chuck Mambo after that first match, and then you could tell that he wanted to get back at Chuck Mambo to the point that he aligned himself with Spike Gervais. Unthinkable decision from Cara Noir, which basically suggests what this obsession with Chuck Mambo and the Riot Cabaret Championship.
Well, Mambo got caught there as he went for the kick as a drop toe hold, though. And Mambo try and hook up Cara Noir. If he can get a hold of the arms here, get a hold of the ears at the moment. It is more than a world title match. It is a revenge mission here for Chuck Mambo. Mambo normally so happy-go-lucky, but wants to inflict pain here on Cara Noir, and he's going to try and do it with a Mexican surfboard. Cara Noir
maybe
hanging in midair.
Maybe Cara Noir is probably going to pay for what he's been doing, for what he's been putting TK Mambo through, and for the disgusting actions that we saw earlier tonight.
Face first goes Cara Noir into the canvas. I'll tell you what, we're seeing a side to Chuck Mambo that doesn't normally reveal itself, Sean. When you hurt his friend, when you hurt TK Cooper, especially on Cooper's 30th birthday, that is bringing something out of Chuck Mambo that I don't think we've seen in Riot Cabaret history up till now.
We've seen how strong the friendship between Sunshine Machine are. They're like the life and soul of Riot Cabaret.
Hold on.
Oh, Jesus.
Noir brought up there.
What's happening here? Oh!
And it was high stakes and it was high reward in the end for Chuck Mambo. Second rope, Hurricane Rana takedown of Cara Noir.
Chuck Mambo's going to have two things in his mind here, or needs to have two things in his mind. First, obviously, get something for TK, but also the Riot Cabaret Championship is on the line. You can't let emotions take over.
I want a counter from Mambo. Oh, no, but another counter.
Uh-oh, danger here.
This one from Cara Noir. But Mambo counters the counter. And Noir grabbing the top rope to try and save his chances of winning the world title. Mambo to the ropes, shot with the forearm, sends Cara Noir down to the outside.
Holy Jesus!
Wow. High in the air in the Clapham Grand, Chuck Mambo launches himself onto Cara Noir. And if you are just joining us, if you're wondering why the intensity here from Chuck Mambo, as while TK Cooper was receiving a birthday message from his parents back in New Zealand, for goodness sake, that Cara Noir launches assault tonight and basically was able to work his way into a world title match against Mambo.
Holy shit, it's no disqualification.
No disqualification here. The table will be all legal, but Mambo took his eye off Karen Wild for just a moment, and he might regret bringing that table into play because it's now in the hands of the Black Swan.
And that.
This pursuit of the world title, this resentment of Chuck Mambo has poisoned the mind of Cara Noir, who has evil intentions. But Mambo's going to the ropes. Oh, trying to follow Noir out, but Noir threw back into the ring.
Oh, Swan Wu.
It's that kick right into the abdomen there. And then a rebound into the German suplex. Off the ropes came the world champion.
Oh!
Kicked to the side of the head with that bare foot of Cara Noir. Noir will look for the neck breaker. See how Mambo's neck snapped over the shoulder of the man who might be about to be world champion, but Mambo kicked out on 2 3/4. A lot of people were very, very surprised. They thought it was an upset. Oh my. When Mambo defeated Cara Noir back at the grand opening in June. Cara Noir looking to make sure that lightning does not strike twice. If he's successful in that mission, he's going to become the second ever Riot Cabaret World Champion. Remember also, Sean, of course, that as per earlier tonight, somewhere waiting in the wings, Michael Oku is the new number one contender for whoever wins this. Ooh. Oof. Mambo lost his balance on the apron, and it might be for the best. A swing and a miss there from Cara Noir. Mambo, remembering it's no disqualification rules, trying to get another table out, but Cara Noir cuts him off midway through that effort.
Mambo keeps going for this table, and it keeps backfiring on him.
Showing very little interest in the table.
Again, I think this is what we were talking about earlier, about the emotions. Oh, wait, he's got
the
that
cucumber. Oh, that was a gift. That was a gift. And you've broken it. A cucumber smashed over the head of Chuck Mambo. Striking down on the back of Cara Noir. Noir is in trouble here against Mambo, but he's not anymore because, again, it's all legal. Steel chair shot from Cara Noir. And Cara Noir going to bring that steel chair into the ring. Brings it down hard across the back. As the world champion,
hasn't he done enough damage with a steel chair this evening? Like, come enough with the chair already.
There is no depth to which Cara Noir will not stoop if it brings him that world title. As I said, he has become obsessed with this championship. Will that quest fly?
What is happening?
He doing? Oh, drops Mambo hard. Face first into the steel. He's got a smile on his face. Mambo kicks out on 2 on the pin attempt. Right, Cabaret fans are giving Cara Noir an earful here. Doubt he will remotely care if he gets what he came for.
Oh wait, we saw this happen earlier. If he's going for Madame Guillotine again, we could say we'd be a new world champion right here.
Yeah, this is put TK Cooper on the shelf. Remember, this should be TK Cooper's world title opportunity.
Yeah, keep forgetting this. This should be Mambo versus TK. They said they were going to put the greatest match on for us.
On Cooper's 30th birthday, no less.
And Cara is just taking all of this away from everybody.
Well, hang on now. Who's removed the gum shield. Now Mambo with his teeth around the chair and God, nearly lost his teeth. Thank God that Mambo moved out of the way. Mambo to the ropes now. And Mambo, the reef break, the pin, and the kick out from Noir.
No disqualifications. He was in the ropes. It's all legal. Tom Scarborough, his easiest job of the night is just to count to three and call the submission in this one.
And again, it's the first time in Riot Cabaret history that we have presented to you such a dangerous match. No disqualification here. All weapons legal. These two can do anything they want to each other in pursuit of that world title. Mambo will send Noir to the corner. No, he won't, because Noir has a very firm grip on that middle rope. So, another shot to the side of the head. Mambo trying to get a backside, trying for a gory bomb maybe. And hang on, look where he's headed. Sean, you don't think.
Is he going to go for this? Go on, Chuck. Oh, no.
Noir counted. If Noir gets a sunset flip, that could be Mambo who goes into the chair. Hang on.
Reverse into a catapult here. Oh!
Head first into the steel. And it couldn't happen to a nicer guy. The pin. And oh, kick out. Kick out, kick out, kick out. Well, that would have made TK Cooper's 30th birthday at least a little bit better if Chuck Mambo finish the job there against Caranoir. Where is he going here? Let's see if we can still see where he is. Chuck Mambo has vanished. Well, hold on. It's a beach ball.
Is that a thumbtack beach ball?
What on earth? The spike's facing outwards. Caranoir can't quite believe what he's seeing. A drop toe!
Oh!
And Mambo went face first into his own beach ball. Caranoir grinding.
Oh.
Those spikes rolling them down the body of Chuck Mambo. Going into the most painful part of the body. Taking the air out of the ball, taking the air out of the building, quite honestly.
I mean, now there's just thumbtacks in the ring, and Caro's just walking around with no boots on. It's
over the top,
jeez,
they both go.
Cactus clothesline over the top.
I'm not sure there was much strategy to that. I think that was just pure rage.
Well, this is just an absolute war, isn't it?
Chuck Mambo scooping up Caranoir.
Oh.
Dropping him on his spine, right on the ring apron, on the edge of the ring. Now he's got the table again. Mambo gonna bring the table under the bottom rope, I think, into the ring. Mambo has set up the table, and Caranoir may yet rue the fact that he ruined TK Cooper's birthday bonanza earlier on.
That
looks
like
that as well. He may have ended TK Cooper's career. We still don't know exactly what condition Cooper is in. We know he wasn't able to compete here. And wow, look at that. Self-preservation from the Black Swan. And a low blow. No disqualification. Caranoir with Madame Guillotine. The move on the chair that put out Cooper earlier. Will it bring him the world title? No, it won't. Mambo's world title seemed to be in jeopardy like never before. But he dug deep. He found a way to kick out. And our main event of Fights and Delights rolls on.
Now Caro's got the boss. Creativity of misery for Caro this evening is been intense and extreme. What is he going to come up with this for this table?
That table right in the middle of the ring now. What is Noir doing?
Jesus.
Well, I think I know what he's doing. I hope I don't. I hope he's not doing what I think he is.
What do you reckon he's going to do?
No,
Wow, yeah, superplex?
Like, it looks like a superplex.
Jesus.
And look where that table is. Psychotic.
Like, jeez, lucky for Mambo there, falling to the outside.
Carenoir is just utterly psychotic. There is no other word for the sadism we're seeing from Carenoir here. Noir trying to deadlift up Chuck Mambo, but he can't do it.
Cross chop.
Mambo's
Jesus
fighting for survival.
Christ, what is he going to think? What is he thinking of here?
Hang on. Now Mambo. Mambo, springboard. Gets his balance. Oh, but he got caught. Oh, God, no.
No way.
Oh, God, no. Oh! Carenoir sending Chuck Mambo head first into the table, and the table did not break, for pity's sake.
I don't think he even tried to break the table. I think he purposely aimed to get Chuck Mambo's spine onto the edge of that table.
It was the head, the back of the neck that I think took the brunt of the impact, and thank God Chuck Mambo is still moving.
Whoa. Oh,
Carenoir losing it here. Roll up from Mambo. Mambo tried to take Noir by surprise, but he couldn't do it. Mambo eating a series of elbow smashes here from Carenoir. How on earth is Chuck Mambo even still standing, let alone still the world champion? Mambo, double-handed strike to the side of the head of Noir, but Noir fires back with authority.
Watch out.
Mambo brings the top rope down, Noir to the outside. Here comes Mambo, off the ropes. Chuck Mambo between the top and middle. A torpedo dive into Carenoir. But Noir going to hit one of his own, is he? Over the top.
Oh,
wiping out Mambo. Noir brings Mambo back in. Mambo might not stay in. Off the top.
Oh!
Somersault dive. Is there anything that these two men will not do to each other in this no disqualification contest? Mambo brings him back in, looking to end this. It's a clothesline from Noir. Carenoir's dark obsession with the world title means that he just refuses to stay down here. Men just knocking chunks out of each other here. A war of attrition between Chuck Mambo and Carenoir for the world title.
It's not just for the world title though, is it, Dave?
For much more than that, it has become so personal.
Oh,
between
Christ.
Noir and Mambo after what Noir did to TK Cooper earlier on. Ripcord, but a lariat comes from Mambo, not from Noir. The crowd comes alive! They're feeling it, but oh no! Noir fires back. Carenoir fires back. Mambo! Destroyer from Chuck Mambo! The headbutt. Mambo might be unconscious, though he's not. He rolls on top, in fact, and Noir was very, very close to losing the match there. Both these men running on fumes alone at this point. It is Chuck Mambo, Carenoir, both men down, and the Riot Cabaret Championship of the World hanging in the balance in our main event. Well, that ball was deflated, but the spikes are still there. Mambo placing that ball on the chest of Noir.
What is he thinking here? Is he thinking for the...
Sean, you don't think that Chuck Mambo...
This is going to hurt you as much as it's going to hurt... Oh!
Noir moved out of the way.
No!
He's going to hit a... Don't do that! A two-foot fire driver on the thumbtacks! Carenoir! To win the world title this time!
Oh.
Oh my God! How? Noir's still not done. Noir will stay right on top of him, his body weight down on the shoulders. Mambo's still able to kick out, but he walks right into a super kick. To that frustrated roar from Cara Noir. Noir pummeling, pounding at Chuck Mambo. Referee might have to call this off.
Mate, this might be done here.
Mambo's unconscious. No, no, don't call it. Don't call it. Well, Cooper's out here. TK Cooper's out here. I didn't see where Cooper came from. TK Cooper has obviously recovered enough, which is good to see. Inside cradle, the small package from Mambo, and it's a kick out from Noir. Oh, Mambo's got nothing left. Oh my God, Mambo, Sean, Mambo's got nothing.
Mate, I don't want to see this reign end like this.
Package pile driver from Cara Noir. And Noir looking back towards TK Cooper, staring in the eyes of the man whose 30th birthday is ruined here tonight in the Clapham Grand. Noir and Cooper, eyeball to eyeball here. Has Mambo got anything left? Has Chuck Mambo got anything left? Can he find a way to hold on to the world title?
Come on, TK, just get in there and smash him up.
He's on his feet. Oh, no, he's not. Blackout sleeper. The blackout sleeper from Cara Noir. Stay with us, Mambo. Stay with us. He's got the shoulders down. Oh, Mambo.
Come on, Mambo.
Noir rolls back through. Noir rolls back through. The blackout.
Come on, TK, man.
Oh, Cooper's got nothing left. Cooper's got nothing left either. Mambo is fading. Mambo trying to reach his tag team partner. The blackout sleeper cinched in by Cara Noir. Mambo! Mambo! Is he out? Is he out? Noir staring deep into the eyes of Cooper! Oh my God, no!
Here is your winner and the new Riot Cabaret World Champion, Cara Noir!
Damn it!
I cannot believe that is how the reign of Chuck Mambo has ended.
Cara Noir has just ended the reign of Chuck Mambo. He has avenged his loss in the first ever match in Riot Cabaret history. And after a ruthless power play on TK Cooper's 30th birthday, Cara Noir has taken everything that Sunshine Machine held dear. An evil smirk crosses the face of the Black Swan. His obsession for the world title has finally been quenched at Fights and Delights. Cara Noir era begins in Riot Cabaret.